We all know someone who's so passionate about animals that they're willing to adopt a stray cat. But sometimes even the crazy cat lovers themselves have totally no idea who exactly is sharing their home. Eric Hertland's grandmother, a fanatical animal lover, has a reputation for taking in stray cats. She sets her porch up with food, water, plus soft and warm beds, making it a safe refuge for all the homeless animals in the neighborhood. Therefore, when a poor little thing showed up outside her home a couple of months ago, Grandma regarded it as another kitty in need and invited it inside. However, she did not know what precisely the stray animal was. When Eric swung by his grandma's house for a regular visit, he wasn't shocked to see baskets all over the house with kittens sleeping in them. However, he couldn't help but take notice of and a closer look at the newest addition. The cat snuggling up in a corner amongst all of the others, who was enjoying a nice comfy bed of its own. It was not a cat at all. Eric thought the creature had snuck into the house secretly, which made him kind of panic. And how and when the wild imposter got in? Had it done something harmful to his grandma or any of the cats? He was alarmed and confused, but grandma didn't understand why her grandson had seemed so shocked by her cat. Grandma explained that the kitty in the corner had been coming around for a while and that she had named him Ted. Trying to calm Eric's nerves, she reassured me it was one of her cats. Eric told the local news. I told her it wasn't what she thought it was. I laughed for a good 5 minutes, Eric said. She didn't realize what I was laughing about until I started pointing out at the pointy nose and skinny tail. She didn't realize he wasn't a cat. Eric revealed to his grandmother that her guest was definitely not a kitty, but an opossum. The opossum is the only marsupial found in the US and categorically not a cat. They are usually solitaire and nomadic, staying in one area as long as food and water are readily available. When scared or threatened, they will play possum, which means they mimic the appearance and smell of a dead animal. Well, Eric's grandmother is definitely not the first one to be tricked by a sneaky opossum. When Tate was first taken in by Eric's grandma, he was still a tiny baby like this. It might explain why he had been mistaken for a kitty. Both of them are pretty fluffy and cute. This is a picture shared by a Reddit user and his office cat. My cat turns into a possum after a bath. Now that he mentions it, we can see the likeliness between the two species. No wonder Eric's grandma regarded Tate as a cat. Realizing that she had an opossum in her home for the past few weeks, Eric's grandma was really confused at first. She kind of just sat there, Eric recalled. She then got a little closer and slowly looked up at me with the biggest grin on her face and said, "Well, he hasn't bothered me yet. So, I'm okay with him being here." Therefore, Tate was welcomed by this very kind and compassionate lady, just as if he was a cat. Even after finding out the truth, Eric's grandma still saw him as a welcome house guest. She loves animals and taking care of them whenever she can, Eric said. It kind of just motivates you to do better and treat other beings better too. We couldn't agree more, right?